summer is upon us, and whatever you have going on, a vacation, a staycation, a summer wedding, well, Macy's has you covered. If you need summer dresses, matching sets, volume sleeve tops, wedges, straw-crafted bags, I mean, really, they have what you need head to toe. I'm talking Levi's, Dolce Vita, Lacoste, and more. So shop summer must-haves at Macy's. Go to Macy's.com/ownyourstyle. Again, that's Macy's.com/ownyourstyle. Host Nora McInerney is back for season 2 of The Head Start, Embracing the Journey, a podcast from Ruby Studio and AbbVie. In each episode, Nora has real conversations with real people living with chronic migraine to see how they took action to understand this disease. So jump into the conversation for season 2, a show that creates a little more space for empathy and understanding in such a complicated world. There shouldn't be so much hesitation around asking questions and asking for help. So don't wait. Join The Head Start, Embracing the Journey, and learn a little more about life with chronic migraine. What kind of programs does this school have? How are the test scores? How many kids to a classroom? Homes.com knows that these are all the things that you ask when you're home shopping as a parent. That's why each listing on Homes.com includes extensive reports on local schools, including photos, parent reviews, test scores, student-teacher ratio, school rankings, and more. The information is from multiple trusted sources and curated by Homes.com's dedicated in-house research team. It's all so you can make the right decision for your family. Homes.com, we've done your homework. In every pair of Tecovas boots, you can expect handmade quality, first wear comfort, and timeless Western style. Tecovas boots are always made from premium bovine and exotic leathers, and with occasional resoling, they're going to last a lifetime. The best way to shop for boots is at your local Tecovas store, where you're going to be greeted by the smell of fresh leather and a friendly smile. So come on in, grab a cold one, get fitted by a pro, and shop the latest styles. Visit Tecovas.com. That's Tecovas.com. And don't go gently, y'all. Happy Tuesday. Welcome to The Fifth Thing. I'm Amy.
And I'm Kat.
And today's quote comes to us from our Four Things Gratitude Journal that Mary and I made for Espoir, which Espoir means hope in Haitian Creole. Our journals support Haiti. We don't have that many left, to be honest, but that's for another thing. If you want one, fourthings.com is where you can get it, but that's not why I'm bringing this up. It's just where I'm pulling the quote from, because today's episode is going to be all about gratitude. It's a gratitude remix, and we're resharing some things that past guests have said that they're thankful for whenever I ask them to do Four Things Gratitude. But Amy Morin is a quote that we included in our journal, or she has a quote that we included, and it's, "Developing an attitude of gratitude is one of the simplest ways to improve your satisfaction with life." And it is a simple way that can help at least point you in that direction of satisfaction and realizing that you do have things to be thankful for. And something else that we included in the back of the journal are prompts, because sometimes thinking of something that you're thankful for is really hard. Do you ever have that?
Yeah, because in my head, I sometimes am like, it has to be this big thing. And so I'm like, nothing big happened today, but really it can be the tiniest little tiny thing.
Yes. That's why also too, in the journal, we included stickers, because sometimes you just don't have the words. So you can be like, oh, okay.
Pizza,
sticker, cookie, wine. Like there's all kinds of different stickers for, like, you can look at it and be like, oh, did I have one of these that helped? And maybe you just have one word to write down, or maybe you have a whole paragraph. But we put prompts in the back, and I'll just read through a few so that way you can keep them in mind for if you're trying to lean into gratitude a little bit more. But I'll ask you some of these, Kat, okay? These are prompts, all right?
I feel like I'm being put on the spot.
Well, you're not.
Okay.
What brings you joy?
Can I this be rapid fire? Because the first thing that popped in my head was laughing.
Yes.
Okay.
It is rapid fire.
Okay.
Rapid fire-ish, because you know you and I are not.
Okay, so then this rapid fire questions with you brings me joy.
Oh, okay. What is something that made you smile today?
A text message that I got from my boyfriend. That was very sweet.
Yeah, it was. Patrick, she didn't read it to me. I just know a little bit about it, but it was amazing. It kind of made me smile too, I'm not going to lie. Do you have a roof over your head?
Yes.
See? Boom. Gratitude.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did you have hot water when you wanted to wash your face this morning or take a shower?
For sure.
Yeah. Gratitude.
I didn't have air conditioning last week, though.
Yeah. Do you have access to water in general?
I do.
Yeah. See, these are some prompts. Like, there's some more that'll bring you back to reality of like, oh, I do have things to be grateful for, because there's literally people that don't have access to clean water. Okay, another prompt we have in our Four Things Gratitude Journal is, can you not put down that amazing book, which I am reading, The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, right now, and it is so good.
Like, that's a fiction.
It's fiction, and I don't like fiction, but I'm into this.
You know what? Actually, I'm not reading a book, but I got so excited, and I'm grateful for this, for a book that I'm about to read called Someone Other Than a Mother by Erin Lane, and I interviewed for her for You Need Therapy today, and I'm very grateful that she put out the book, because we talked about what it's about.
So, ooh,
yeah.
Awesome.
Shout out. Yeah.
How's your eyesight?
Really bad.
Oh, okay. Well, do you have glasses or contacts?
Is that a prompt?
Yes.
Nuh-uh.
It's yes. We put these in order. We say, how's your eyesight? Because maybe it isn't good, but do you have glasses or contacts?
I have both, yes.
Okay, see, gratitude.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Ah, boom. Did you find Siete chips at your grocery store?
Is that in there?
Yes, because Mary and I love Siete chips, but we just love Siete, the company as a whole. We've obviously heard us talk about them before if you're an avid listener, but we probably made these prompts when they weren't in every store. Now I feel like Siete is pretty mainstream, but it used to be like, oh, yay, Siete is now in the Target by my house, or it's now at my Publix grocery store or whatever, and we would just get happy for them, and plus Siete chips are good. We put, did you just find out that Chick-fil-A is now open on Sundays?
Stop.
JK, JK, JK.
I was going to say, that's so rude.
I know. We actually put JK on there because that would definitely be gratitude, because obviously you crave Chick-fil-A the most when it's Sunday. Mm-hmm. What were you going to ask?
Oh, I was going to say, I got gratitude, a surprise shot of gratitude, when I went to my refrigerator in my office last week, and I had put those Siete chips in there that you had brought me that one day, and I forgot they're in there. And I was like, yes.
See? Gratitude.
There was some guacamole in there too, but it wasn't good anymore.
Has Google helped you figure something out lately?
Yes. I just Googled something about sunlight in front of you.
Yeah. So we have access to things like Google. Has Urban Dictionary helped you really figure something out? I forgot we hit that one in there. That's funny.
Yes, for sure.
That will give you all the cool kids
are
saying.
What we should have done?
What?
We should have Urban Dictionaried the meaning of our name.
Oh, we'll do it right now.
Okay.
I mean, and I'll go through some more prompts and I can answer them while you're looking them up. Did you get boarding group A on your flight? That's for all you Southwest people. Shout out. And you know it feels good if you're boarding Southwest and you have A group. Has the house unexpectedly been cleaned? Well, yes, but mostly by me. But still, it feels good and I have gratitude that I'm able to clean my house. Have you realized today that you're killing it? Yeah, some days. Rewards points get you that trip home to see your family. Ooh, which I have a Southwest credit card and I get my points. That's what I put everything on. And I get a lot of points that way and book free flights. This is not a commercial for Southwest, by the way. Are you thankful for the 5-minute Tracy Anderson arm video on YouTube? Which, yes, I am. That 5-minute arm workout video, it's called, if you just Google into YouTube, Tracy Arms for Gwyneth, it'll pop up. It's a 5-minute arm workout that she created for Gwyneth Paltrow when she was training for Iron Man to be in the first movie. And by training, I don't know what that means, but I guess because she was Iron Man's helper, maybe she just wanted to have a certain workout. But anyway, I love that 5-minute video. It is my favorite. It doesn't require any weights. All you need is your arms. And I'm thankful for my arms.
And you've done it on the phone with me before.
I've done it.
On FaceTime. You do it any, it's like.
I do it anytime. I even have it memorized because I've been doing it for so many years. And it's not something I do every single day. But I am thankful for it because it's, sometimes that's my workout for the day. I move my body. I'm like, whoop, did my 5-minute arms. But I'll take my dog in the backyard and I'll be like, okay. And I know the routine and kind of how she does it. And while I'm waiting for my dog to use the bathroom, I just do my memorized YouTube video for my arms. And it's, you're not using any weights, but you feel that burn. And you feel like accomplished when you get done with it. And you're like, okay, boom. All right, did you find what our names mean on Urban Dictionary?
I did. And I will say I like these better. So do you want me to do mine or yours first?
Yours.
Okay. Do you want me to use Kat or Catherine?
Both.
Okay.
Okay.
They're different girls. So Cat, I think it just describes the person who is Cat. So Cat is talented in many areas, but the greatest thing about her is her heart. She's kind and always ready to comfort someone who's upset. She would generally be quite successful in the performing arts, especially if that's where her interests are. She's great at advice and she's easy to talk to, but never makes judgments. She's often taken for granted and overlooked. She's a beautiful person, both appearance and personality. Thank you.
Wow, this is detailed.
If you have a friend like this, don't ever underestimate them or take them for granted. If you're lucky enough to have a friend like this, keep her and don't let anyone hurt her because she wouldn't let anyone hurt you. They use it in a sentence like a normal dictionary would. There aren't enough people like Kat in this world. And then another person says back to that, I know this Kat personality is beyond reach for most people to acquire in their lifetime.
Huh. Okay, what about Catherine? I didn't realize they were this long.
I know. Well, I'll just read the highlights of Catherine. Catherine, a girl who is amazing, beautiful, gorgeous, and practically perfect. She has eyes like a goddess. They sparkle in the light. Her eyes are best noticed when she laughs and smiles. She always is able to make someone laugh and gives the best hugs and goes on. It just says a lot of wonderful things about me.
Wow. So yeah. If you see like a goddess, you say, oh, that's a Catherine. Oh.
Well, used in a sentence. Guy one, Catherine is so amazing. I wish she was mine. Guy two, I know, dude. Her eyes are amazing. I get lost in them.
That's right.
Girl one, I'm so jealous of Catherine, but at the same time, I just love her personality and her smile.
Oh, wow. Catherine's okay. Perfect. Okay, what does
that
it say about
really,
Amy?
Really, like, spot on for me. So Amy's is not so long.
Oh, it's like one sentence. Go ahead.
Amy is the kindest and most loving person you will ever meet. I feel like they said that about Kat, but it's okay. Amy is one in a million and will always put others before herself and can also turn any situation into a happy one. She is extremely sexy and has the body of a goddess.
I can already say that to a lot of those. I am not any of that.
If you ever get in a relationship with Amy, it'll be a relationship for life because there's no one better. And you better bleep treat her the way she deserves. Do you want it used in a sentence?
Sure.
Dang, look at that body. That must be an Amy.
Oh my gosh. Okay, I don't know how I feel about Urban Dictionary's.
But remember, aren't you... What are you? Beloved.
Oh, that's what my name is.
So if you want to go back to that, you can.
Beloved. And then what does Catherine mean again?
Perfect.
Perfect.
I'm just kidding. No. It's pure.
Yeah, pure. That's right. This is from a previous episode where we looked up what our names mean. So all this to circle back to gratitude and what are you thankful for today? And do you need some prompts in your life? Well, we just gave you several. And then just to describe the journal that we have, I'm holding it right now, and it's like these really pretty coral colors, like an ombre effect. And the four things that we put on our gratitude journal: love hard, choose joy, laugh often, give thanks. And it makes like a great little gift for someone in your life or maybe even for yourself. And it supports education in Haiti through Project MediShare. So yeah, fourthings.com if you happen to be interested in a journal, or if you want to participate in Four Things Gratitude. You don't have to have the journal to do it by any means. You could type it into your phone or you could get any notebook and just write down four things. And if four things is too intimidating, start with one. Mm-hmm. Just that one thing. Mm-hmm. And do rapid fire. Answer it. That one question. Mm-hmm. And figure it out. And then you can build on top of that. Okay, so what we're doing today, which it's a holiday week, but we thought it would be fun to revisit things that guests on the show have been thankful for and share their four things gratitude. So that's what we're going to get into right now. So maybe it'll be some inspo for you. Mm-hmm. All right, we'll start out with some four things gratitude inspo from Hilary Scott.
Okay, my four things are I am so unbelievably thankful for just my faith, my relationship with God, and knowing that how he sees me and also, you know, how he sees all of us. Getting back to the grace piece, it's like the grace that's extended from him that we should extend to ourselves and others. So that would be number one. I am so grateful for my husband, especially in this season that we're in right now of just endless patience and understanding and blood, sweat, and tears. I mean, he is amazing. I am very, very thankful for my family, my mom, my dad, my little sister. And when I say husband, I mean my family with him too. My daughters, Isley, Emery, and Betsy. And then my immediate family, my mom, my dad, my baby sister, Riley. And then lastly would be just my Lady A family, like getting to walk this career with people that I love and respect and who just really help spur me on to be a better version of myself and what Lady A has, the platform that it's given us. It's hard to pick four, mm-hmm. but those would be my four.
I know.
And they're all very, like, and if you can't tell this about me, like, my relationships are hands down the most important thing to me. I appreciate so much the comforts of this life and that we are feel so blessed to have, but it is so much more about the people you get to live life with.
All right, you gotta love a place that makes shopping for gifts super easy, because heads up, Father's Day is June 16th and Macy's has got you covered. Their ultimate gift guide makes shopping for the dad or the dad figure in your life super easy. You can shop by price, 25 and under, 50 and under, 100 and luxe. You can shop by category, like cologne, watches, leather goods. You can even shop by gift lists. Like if your dad loves to grill, then shop for grill master things. If your dad loves to golf, then you can go to the gift list that is for the golfer. I mean, really, Macy's has thought of it all. If you have a tech-savvy dad, voila, Macy's Gift Finder, again, has you covered with that. Top gifts include Beats headphones, JBL portable speakers, Nintendo Switch, and more. Top brands such as Calvin Klein, Tommy Hilfiger, Polo Ralph Lauren, Columbia, and more. Really, Macy's has it all, so don't be a last-minute shopper. Father's Day is June 16th. Make sure to check out Macy's.com/giftfinder to find a unique gift they'll love. I don't want to waste my time taking vitamins that aren't really going to do much for me. Like, I want research. I want to know, like, hey, this is actually doing something for my body. And Ritual knows this. That's why they conducted the research. They've done clinical trials on their Essential for Women 18 Plus multivitamin. The results? Well, it increased vitamin D levels by 43% and omega-3 DHA levels by 41% in just 12 weeks. And as a woman, I want healthy vitamin D levels and omega-3 levels. And all I got to do is take my Ritual Essential for Women 18 Plus multivitamin every morning. I take them on an empty stomach, but sometimes if I forget, I may take them in the afternoon. It's really up to you when you want to take them. There's 9 key nutrients in 2 delayed release capsules. And what the delay release capsules does for us is it optimizes our body's absorption of these nutrients. It's gentle on the empty stomach. Like I said, I can take it first thing in the morning and I'm totally fine. And with a minty essence in every bottle, it actually makes taking your vitamins enjoyable. No more shady business. Ritual's Essential for Women 18 Plus is a multivitamin that you can actually trust. Get 25% off your first month at ritual.com/4things. Start Ritual or add Essential for Women 18 Plus to your subscription today. That's ritual.com/4things for 25% off. This show is sponsored by BetterHelp. Something that I've learned in therapy is that goals are really important. Like, it can really help you out. Like, when life is going so fast, it's important to take a moment to celebrate how far you've come, celebrate those wins, but also look forward to where you're going. Make adjustments for the rest of the year, and therapy can help you take stock of your progress and set achievable goals for the next 3 months, the next 6 months. I have personally benefited from therapy in so many ways. I feel like we'd be here all day if I were to tell you all of the ways therapy has helped me out, giving me tools to have in my back pocket for when I need to bust them out, coping skills, how to set boundaries. I feel so much more empowered because of therapy. So I'm very thankful for it. If you're thinking of starting therapy, well, give BetterHelp a try. It's entirely online, designed to be convenient, flexible, and suited to your schedule. Take a moment, visit betterhelp.com/4things today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/4things. Again, you're going to get 10% off your first month. In every pair of Tecovas boots, you can expect handmade quality, first wear comfort, and timeless Western style. A great pair of Western boots will elevate a casual look or add a refined flair that'll draw both eyes and compliments. Tecovas boots are always made from premium bovine and exotic leathers, and with occasional resoling, they will last a lifetime. Now, the best way to shop for boots is at your local Tecovas store, where you're going to be greeted by the smell of fresh leather and a friendly smile. So come on in, grab a cold one, get fitted by a pro, and shop the latest styles. They also offer custom branding and leather stamping if you want to personalize your boots or fine leather goods. And stay cool in a short sleeve moisture wicking pearl snap. Or make your own shade with one of their classic straw hats, new in both men's and women's styles. And if you're planning to hit the road, Tecovas' ever-growing lineup of rugged and full-grain leather bags will get you where you're headed in style, and they are built to last decades. Visit tecovas.com. That's T-E-C-O-V-A-S.com. And don't go gently, y'all. Our girl Kelsea Ballerini has done four things gratitude before as well.
Four things I'm thankful for. A good cup of coffee in the morning. It really helps me start my day on the right foot. I'm thankful for my friends. I know who they are. They are the best. I am thankful for ambition. I think ambition is like a really wonderful like secret weapon.
Like Dolly says, pour yourself
a cup of ambition with your coffee. And I am thankful for quality time, whether that's with my husband or in a meet and greet with someone that I get to meet for the first time, whatever. I'm thankful for like moments of quality time.
Good. I like those four things.
Is that all right?
Yeah. Okay. There's no, I mean, really, what you can be grateful for any given day is going to be up to you.
Yeah. Okay.
But I
That's
do like those.
Today.
And our hope is that it just encourages other people to take time to think of what they're grateful for.
Yeah.
Because there is really no joy without gratitude. That's from Brené Brown. So, and she knows what she's talking about.
Yes.
There's research attached to anything that she says. And we'll end with some gratitude from the women in Little Big Town. We'll start off with Kimberly Schlapman.
I have to tell you, it's because of you that now my Daisy and I, before we go to bed, we write down four things we're grateful for.
Oh, yeah.
I'm really grateful to you for giving me that idea. And so, yeah, we do it together now. And I mean, we don't do it together, but we each do it. You know, we've made that commitment together.
I love that.
Me too.
Yeah.
Okay, so this was really hard as I thought of narrowing it down to four things, but I'm really grateful for hugs. I love physical touch, and we talked about this a little bit before. I love that I can reach out and hug and show affection to the people.
Well, that's your love language, probably, physical touch.
Oh,
that's one of them.
I bet so. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Problem solved.
Okay, thank
you. Don't even have to take the quiz.
I have to read the book.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay, good. Done. And with the pandemic, I mean, we don't get to, when I walked here in the door here today, I couldn't hug you because of the pandemic. And I really miss hugging the people that I want to love on. But also, I feel like we need the touch. Like, when I did lose my first husband, I found out that skin to skin, when we touch skin to skin, it gives us a chemical in our brain called oxytocin, which is a feel-good chemical, and we need that. And when I did lose my husband, my counselor told me, get massages. And this is a tip for anyone out there who has lost a loved one. Get a massage because you need that skin-to-skin contact because it releases oxytocin in your brain. So hugs, I think we need. I want to get it back where we can hold each other's hand and hug on each other because I think it's so important.
So you're grateful for hugs.
Grateful for hugs.
Second thing.
Number two, I'm grateful for health, which is kind of a common answer, I'm sure, especially because the pandemic has brought us, we've become so aware and grateful for health that we have. For me also, it's, I'm watching my parents get older, and I know that you've lost your mom. I'm so sorry. My parents are older, and they also have some challenges now. My mother has Parkinson's, and growing up, I thought Parkinson's just meant, you know, your hand shakes or your leg shakes, but there's so much more to that wretched disease than just tremors, and I watch her daily with the challenges that she has, and her whole life has always been so independent, and she has run everywhere and done anything she wanted, and she's always been on the go, like me, like I am now, but now she can't do that. She's much more slow. She has to be slow with her movements and with her steps because of her Parkinson's, and so that, watching her, it makes me super thankful for what the health that I still have in my body. But it also makes me thankful for the health that she still has, because I still have her, and her challenges are becoming greater, but I am still grateful for the health that she does have. So health in a big broad term, you know, just not for myself, but for the people that I love.
That's an important one that we definitely take for granted.
Yeah. Third thing is family. I've already talked about my parents a little bit and how amazing they were, but they made a huge effort to keep us together and to bring us together. And now my sister has her own family, my brother has his own family, but we make an effort to be together, and we make an effort to make memories. And that's something we literally talk about. We're like, let's get together and make some memories, because I think that kind of carries us through our lives, and then our children get a chance to make memories together, and those things are just precious, precious. And also, like we said before, I can't say the word family and not say Little Big Town, because they are now also my family, because we've just lived so much life together, and we hold each other up like family members, and we do anything for each other like family members do. And so family.
And last but not least, some four things gratitude inspo from Karen Fairchild.
The first thing is my family. And during COVID, I didn't see my mom and dad or my brother or my sister, nieces, nephews since last June.
Oh,
and
wow.
That was just really hard because we were used to seeing them a lot. So this past weekend, we were able to see them, just watching like Elijah light up when he sees his grandparents, you know, my mom and dad, and playing with his cousins. It just like reminded me that family is always first. And there was so much joy this weekend just seeing that.
I always want to think I'm putting family first, but there's times where if I really looked at my calendar, I'm like, did I?
Right. I know. I do the same thing. I mean, that's just because we're working women, we're working moms. And so that makes it challenging. Yeah. So family, and of course, Jimmy and Elijah, I mean, they're my life, and being a mom is the greatest thing that's ever happened to me and the hardest thing that's ever happened to me, but so much joy. And even when it's hard, it's still like, I look and go, wow. This human is my responsibility.
I'm doing this.
I'm trying to do this at least.
Yeah.
So family first. Second, I'm going to say the joy of music for me. It's hard to explain the joy that it gives me, whether I'm writing in a room with Lori McKenna and Liz Rose and Hilary Lindsay. And again, I pinch myself to think, how did I get in this room with these extraordinary women? It's like a bit like therapy, you know, and Kimberly, it's a girl's day, and we're writing. And or recently I've been writing with Savannah Santos from Avenue Beat and Elisa Vanderheim, who's a producer and writer, and Maddie Diaz and Ashley Ray and Sarah Buxton. We just have this big girl's day of writing. And that gives me so much joy because we're writing about things that women are talking about and that means something. You know, it's like there's something different. I love writing with guys too, but there's something about writing with women that just like you feel like I can be vulnerable. Just like you and I were talking before we turned the mics on. It's like mom to mom, we can let our guard down. Because we're going through similar things. So I would say just the music, the gift of that. It's almost a high. I feel that same thing when I'm standing in front of an audience and singing The Daughters or singing Girl Crush or singing Boondocks, whatever like that moment is where you feel connection is just the greatest gift of my life. It really is.
While we're on music, before we move on to the third thing, y'all's newest album is Nightfall. But so what's your favorite song from Nightfall?
I would probably say Problem Child, which Jimmy sings, and his vocal is just so vulnerable. But that song is about feeling like you're the black sheep, and it says, what's your problem, child? Because that's always a saying that we've always said, what's wrong with you? What's your problem?
Here, let's play a clip.
What's your problem, child?
Oh gosh, the third thing, I can be super shallow. I'm going to be super shallow now.
Do it.
The third thing. I mean, the third thing would be, you know, like what we've talked about of the visual side of my life, of being creative and dreaming about what if I want to make some dishes or what if I want to design, you know, interior design things. And
that's not shallow.
And, well, just and the fashion thing. And I for a while I got to do that professionally. Like I had a line for a little while. Yeah. And again, I want to say to girls that are out there dreaming, it might not always work, and that's okay. You're not a failure because it didn't work. Sometimes it's a stepping stone to the next thing. And so for me, that was a learning situation. And I learned a lot about the industry of fashion and what to do and what not to do, but it was awesome. You know, and so maybe I'll get to do it again one day. I don't know, but that's definitely on my dream board. Like sometimes I think there's too much good fashion out there and I don't need to do it. And then I'll hear from fans like, but we want you to do it. We want some of the things that you're doing. And so that's still a huge part of my life. When I favorite things, it has to be on my favorite things.
Yes. I'm here for it. So I'll fashion, be a customer. Yes.
You can
be
fashion, thankful. Design, whatever it is.
And you're probably thankful for your tan feather dress thingy that you just
that I just bought. Yeah. I am. And I will share it with you when I wear it. I don't know. I don't even know if it fits. I just bought it. I don't even know what size it is. I was just like,
you'll figure that out later. Yeah.
One glass of wine in and I was like, and that's mine.
Yeah. You can alter it. Okay, fourth thing.
Margaritas with girlfriends.
Love that. I should have had margaritas waiting for us while we recorded.
We can always do that next time.
We'll do it next time. We'll have to have
session
you
two.
And Kimberly on together.
Oh, that
us,
would be
all
so
three
fun.
Of us.
I would love that.
All right, this sun season, evolve your sun care with new Banana Boat 360 coverage. With Advanced Control Mist, it's a new way to spray. It's an all-new bottle for an all-new mist experience that smells great and is incredibly light on your skin. You can even customize your spray. Like, to cover targeted areas, you just tap the trigger lightly, or you can pull the trigger fully for a long, continuous spray, ensuring long-lasting Banana Boat protection. Plus, it's refillable. From sweat-resistant sport formula to kids SPF 50+, this is sun care that'll come in handy when my kids are swimming, playing sports, when I'm hiking, when we're out at the lake, or whatever it is that we're doing outdoors. Shop Banana Boat 360 Mist at Walmart, Target, or Amazon. In every pair of Tecovas boots, you can expect handmade quality, first wear comfort, and timeless Western style. Tecovas boots are always made from premium bovine and exotic leathers, and with occasional resoling, they're going to last a lifetime. The best way to shop for boots is at your local Tecovas store, where you're going to be greeted by the smell of fresh leather and a friendly smile. So come on in, grab a cold one, get fitted by a pro, and shop the latest styles. Visit Tecovas.com. That's Tecovas.com. And don't go gently, y'all. All right, this show is sponsored by BetterHelp. It's a simple truth that no matter who you are, mental health challenges can affect you. And how you manage them can really make all the difference. That's why everyone should have access to mental health support that meets them where they are and helps them get through things. Now, BetterHelp provides online therapy on your schedule. It's flexible, simple to use, and more affordable than in-person therapy. Connect with a licensed therapist selected just for you. Learn more at BetterHelp.com. That's Better, H-E-L-P.com. BetterHelp.com.
Are you feeling overwhelmed by anxiety, struggling to find restful sleep, or plagued by a restless inability to focus? It's time to break free from the chains of mental health challenges and discover a path to healthy living. Welcome to Amen University, founded by renowned psychiatrist and brain health expert, Dr. Daniel Amen. Dr. Amen, alongside a team of esteemed doctors and experts in their fields, understands the struggles you're facing and are here to offer solutions. From debilitating anxiety to sleepless nights filled with worry, our courses are meticulously crafted to target these specific challenges head on. Join us on a journey of transformation led by Dr. Amen and a roster of top-tier professionals. Say goodbye to the constant battle with your mind and embrace a future filled with hope and possibility. Visit our website today to explore our courses and start your journey towards a brighter tomorrow. Use code BRAIN10 and get 10% off. That's code BRAIN10 and get 10% off your first purchase. Amen University, because your mental health matters.